Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming a get ready with me type video on the new ABH Omrizi palette. I did get this in the mail the beginning of this week, so I have actually been wearing this to work and stuff. I just didn't get any time to sit down and film with it, so here I am busting my ass on the weekend. So here is what the palette looks like in case you guys haven't seen it. I think it's so stunning, it's so fun. I will do a bunch of comparisons at the end so you guys can see it up against some of my existing ABH palettes. But as per usual, I want to swatch this for you guys first so you can see it on my skin tone. Okay, so here are the first five shades. We have Wasted, we have Barb, Liddy, Cupcake, Dragon. Liddy is the pressed glitter shade. And then Barb, I actually have all over my lid today. Ooh, these are pretty. So there's the first five shades. So this palette does have 16 shades, whereas the regular ABH palettes only have, I think, 14 shades, just so you guys are aware. And I haven't tested all of these shadows yet. So here are the next five. We have Leo, Gemini, which is the next pressed glitter. And then we have Gorgina, Rizzi, and Anastasia. Anastasia is also on my eyes today. See, I think Leo is not that bright. Like, if you layer it, yes, but I think in, like, if you just swatch it, like, one swipe, it's not that bright, but you can, like, build it up. Also, I don't know, I feel like shades like that on my skin tone, I mean, they're okay, but I don't know. It's hard. I like greens better. I think that's my deal. With colorful shadows, if I had to pick between blue and green, I would pick green. So again, here is the next five. Now we're swatching all the mattes. I didn't even realize they were kind of all in one row here. And there is a black in here as well. So we have New Yorker, OG, Semsa, 1988, BK. I'm guessing me and Omrizi are the same age if she named a shade called 1988, because that's my birth year as well. Okay, a black swatch, kind of, you know. But let me try and build up the black just so we can see. So there's the black. And then there's one shade left called Yugo. And that looks to be like a darker brown, almost like burgundy shade. That one's a little patchy too. I mean, it was fine on my eyes because I just used it to deepen up my outer corner, but here are the swatches. I'm gonna go ahead and insert a close-up of these swatches now. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the swatches. Of course, you guys know I did film this look, so I'm gonna go ahead and insert that right here. If you wanna skip to the end where you just see my final thoughts and comparisons of the palettes, I'll try and remember to leave the time either in the description box or I'll just put it right here so you can skip to it. But yeah, let's get into how I created this eyeshadow look. So guys, I've been playing with this. This will be my third time using this palette. Here's what mine looks like. Looking pretty messy already. Kind of have an idea of what I want to do. Okay, so I'm going to take the shade New Yorker and use this Sephora brush. This is the Pro Crease, and just blend that into my crease very messily. Next, I'm just going to go into the shade OG with the same brush. It looks very close to New Yorker. A lot of people are like really confused why she put both shades in her palette. But you know what? It's her palette. She's allowed to put whatever shade she wants in them. So I really like how those two mattes blend out. I've had no problems with them this whole time I've been using it. Next, I want to go into the shade 1988, which is just a darker matte. I'm using the Sigma Firm Blender E44 and just putting that in the outer half of my crease just to give it some depth. Now I'm going to go back into my bigger blending brush from Sephora and just blend that shade in so there's no harsh lines. And then I'm going to go back into the E44 and take a little BK and press that on to the very outer corner. Again, just to give it some depth. And I'm also going to go into Yugo, which is like the purpley shade. Okay, back in with the Sephora brush. Blending is key, guys. At least this is what I've learned for my eyes and how I like to do my shadow. So I really like this look. Even right now, I could put on a little bit more of New Yorker and call this like a good, simple eyeshadow look for like an everyday situation. So I really, really, really want to play with the shade Barb. And that's like a topper shade. So I think I'm going to do Anastasia and then do Barb on top. So before I wet my brush, I'm going to try it dry. Just going to take this Tarte brush and go into Anastasia. I probably should just dust it off just in case. Ooh, it's pigmented. I haven't used this color yet, so I don't know what to expect. So that shade Anastasia is applying pretty nicely dry, but I want to try it wet. So I'm going to use my Herbivore spray to just wet it. Oh yeah, that already made it more pigmented. Oh, this is pretty. It's like a gold with a pink shift. Okay, so I'm just gonna take that Sigma brush and just blend the light with the dark just so there isn't like a harsh line. Okay, I like it. Now I want to go into Barb. I'm just going to use the same flat brush. And it's not still wet, so maybe I should wet it. This is a lot flakier than Anastasia. Ooh, that's pretty. Do you guys see that? It's so pretty. The color kind of reminds me of a JD Glow shadow I have. So you guys can kind of see the difference from this eye without versus this eye that has the shade Barb on it. Fun! Ooh, I think this look definitely needs like a wing liner, so that's what I'm gonna go do off camera, and then I'll be back to show you guys how I did my lower lash line. Hey guys, so I did film my foundation routine for a different video because I'm doing a wear test. Because I'm doing a wear test on this foundation. This is a sample of the Bite Beauty Micellar Power Something Supercharged Foundation in the shade T120. I am aware it is a tish too dark for me, but that's okay. We're gonna power through. So I'm gonna use my favorite eyeliner brush. This is the Papagrath eyeliner in the shade Extreme Black. Okie dokie, and then I'm gonna reach back into the Amrezy palette, grab a little pencil brush. I really wanna put more of the shade Barb in my inner corner. I don't know that Mom, Anastasia's done a shade like this before. I know indie makeup brands have done such pretty duochromes, but for a mainstream brand, this feels like, especially for ABH, I don't know. I usually feel like they kind of do the more subdued tones. So I'm going to go into OG and sweep that along my lower lash line. And then I'm going to go into 1988, which is the brown. And then I'm just going to blend. Okay, I think I'm going to leave it like that, like really easy and simple. Okay, guys, so I am going to go ahead and do wing liner off camera, and I will be back to show you the final look. Okay, guys, so I added a very dramatic wing. Basically, what happened was things got a little dicey on this end. So it looks extra, extra drama, but that's okay. And I just threw on some mascara and some balm, some lip balm. I actually just got this. Technically not supposed to be buying lip products, but I was so curious to know if this would be a good dupe for the Fresh Balms. And I really like this so far. I've been wearing it at work. This is the Physician's Formula Organic Wear Tinted Lip Treatment with Butter Blend. And the shade I have is Bury Me. So cute. They have a few other shades. Now I have my eye on those, but one is enough. Just gonna enjoy this one while it lasts. Okay, guys, so I thought I'd zoom you out a little bit before I ended this video, but so far I do really like this palette. Now, is this my favorite Anastasia palette? Hard to say, because I feel like the shimmers are a little bit different. Like this blue one was very crumbly, which usually I feel like my Anastasia shimmer shades just glide on like Barb did. So those two, I'm not sure why Leo is so crumbly. If you can see my palette, it kind of fell into the brown shade below. So 1988 has a little bit of Leo in it because again, it was so crumbly. I actually really like all the pinky tones in here. The blue, not my favorite light blue shade. I feel like I've definitely seen a shade like that in other palettes a million times before. And like my Sydney Grace shadows that have that blue are probably a little bit better quality. But overall, the reason I picked this palette up is because I felt like this was gonna be like the modern renaissance of 2020. You know what I mean? Because this one was last decade and, you know, it served us all really well. People of the internet that were getting into makeup in the 2010 through 2019 period in time really, really loved this. But I feel like the Umrizi is just kind of a little bit more upscale, a little bit more pop to it. You know, you can kind of turn this into a daytime, nighttime palette look, which is kind of what I like. Like my look, I think, like I said, if I had just stopped with the matte shades, definitely daytime appropriate, work appropriate. And then like if I was going to a wedding, say, or a fancy dinner or like a work party, I could amp it up with the shimmer shades. So I do like this palette for all those reasons very much. I definitely feel like it's another hit from ABH as far as being like one of those classic palettes that you can buy. Like this could be the only palette you buy this year and you would get a ton of use out of it. I hope that kind of makes sense. So that's kind of my mini little review on this palette. It does have an 18-month shelf life and it is made in the USA. I really like this packaging. It's so fun and the sparkles don't really come out. I also grabbed my Soul Tree palette here, which has a similar glitter vibe. I mean, just makes them look a little fancy, a little extra, which I like so, so very much. So I did compare these palettes with some of the palettes I own. I did kind of determine that these ones were very neutral, so I feel like if you have any of these, you could still get the Amorisi and be okay. Plus, my Modern Renaissance is really old. I bought it when it originally launched, so I don't feel bad about buying the Amorisi palette because I wanted an upgrade, you know? Like, I don't even use Modern Renaissance anymore, to be very honest with you guys, because it's just not what I'm interested in right now. So here is the Amorisi next to Jackie Ina's palette, which everyone basically has dubbed the best launch of 2019. So there's that. I do think there's definitely, like, you could probably dupe this palette, but I didn't see anything like exact as far as the pink and the blue, which I think are the two big standout shades. This is another one that people were saying, you know, Riviera could easily dupe it, but the pink shade Bahamas, which I think is the closest shade to Rizzi, is actually a matte shade in Riviera, and Seashells is actually more green, whereas the blue in Amorisi's palette, Leo, is a lot more blue in person. So that's something to keep in mind. I also have the Carly Bible palette here. Okay, so here it is next to the Carly Bible palette. I, again, didn't really think there were any close shades. Of course, this palette does have duochromes in it, but none of them really say like dupe, 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 you know? Here's my brand new Alyssa Edwards palette next to the Amorisi palette. I haven't even touched this yet, so that's definitely a goal of mine to use that palette this year in 2020. Norvina, I think, had some close references, especially in the neutral category. Same with Soft Glam, but again, these palettes are old now. Like, Soft Glam is an old palette, so I think that if I was like a teenager or a college student walking into Ulta right now, I'd be going straight for this, not the Soft Glam or the Modern Renaissance, if that makes any sense. That's kind of the approach I took when I purchased this palette, was that I was going into it as somebody that didn't own a ton of ABH palettes. So I hope that all made sense to you guys. I hope you enjoyed the comparisons. I would say overall, I think this palette is a really good palette. You definitely need to be careful. That one shade Leo, like I said, I just felt like I had a lot of fallout with it, which I don't remember with my older ABH palettes, but it's also a very shimmery formula. So just wet your brush, you should be okay. Do your eye makeup first and then do your foundation. All of that should prevent any major disasters. Other than that, I don't think I have anything left. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one soon. Bye, guys!